the meaning of Mdugud, the god that transcends boundaries. Today I ask the question, is God from good a German word, or is it a Sumerian word? The German word God, from Old Norse, good or guth, meaning god, from the Proto-Germanic Guda, cognate with the English god and German Gott. I can tell you now, good and Guda are found in the Sumerian language. So is it Proto-Germanic or Ancient Sumerian? I remind you of the rise of Zoism in 2013, which turned out to be a con. Zoism is Sumerian Babylonian neo-paganism, and due to the recent DNA studies on the Vikings, has proven to be a mixture of Southern European and Asian. Scythia Magogia. This is more than likely the Germanic tribe, or should I say later Germanic tribe, for the refugees entered Britain, meaning they were leaving the new establishment. There are differences between the Norwegian, Swedish, and Icelandic Viking tribes. The source for my words here is St. John's College at the University of Cambridge, September 2020. The link is in the description. The DNA studies indicate that this Sumerian narrative does indeed move north, and I have found that many of our languages can be understood in Sumerian.
Do you know me? Do you know what I am? Do you want to know my name?
Tell me.
This is what I am called. I am called Glad of War, Grim Raider, and Fur. I am One Eye. I am also called Highest and True Gessler. I am Grimnir and the Hooded One. I am Allfather, Gondlir, One Bearer. I have as many names as there are winds, as many titles as there are ways to die. My ravens are Yugin and Munin, thought and memory. My wolves are Freki and Geiri. My horse is the gallows. I am Odin!
Let us begin. Good is found in the transliteration of Anzu. Anzu, also known as Duzu, and Mdugud, the god Zu. The transliteration is Mdugud Mushen, who is a lesser divinity or monster in several Mesopotamian religions. Officially, Mdugud means to be defined. The origin is Sumerian. Numerology 7. All of the variant definitions of Im, Du, and Good lead to this figure being fully defined. Using these words, I believe we can also define the ancient religion. In fact, they contain many of the words that are used in mythology. I'm left wondering whether the mythological texts were derived from these names. Remember, the name Mdugud means to be defined. It is not yet defined. The meanings of Mdugud may be surprising. Imi, Im-M, clay, loam, mud, tablet. The alternative meanings, wind, Direction: weather, storm, cloud, rain. All relating to the Fallen One, the red clay brought by the comet, who has the appearance of a fallen angel. Both meanings are applicable. Do, to walk, to go, to come, to sing. Work, totality, to build, make, to mold, cast, to erect something on the ground, to raise up, to set up, to plant, to fasten, apply. Do redirected to Sug, Jin, to bring down, to knock down, also read as done. In addition to Ug, to stand upright, to kill. Do 6, dull, dal, protection, to clothe, to protect, to hide. To protect plus ornament. That would be the Apkallu statues. Dull 6, dull, do, mound, heap, sanctuary, ruins, tell, meaning mound, cleft and cave. Do, to build, erect. Do'ul, ancient, enduring. Do 7, to be finished, complete, to be suitable, fitting, to be necessary, to butt, gore, toss, regularly followed by Ra. Is it just me, or does Ra follow Shesmu through the underworld? Interestingly enough, he was Ra's protector. Where he would butt, gore, or toss the demons of the Egyptian underworld. Ru, meaning bird or god. Aruru would be the alpha bird god, or the land of the bird god, or the land of the bird's sound, the oracle. Do 9, done. Done, oh done, oh din. Done 5, burr, to churn butter, to sway, stagger, to complain, to move and raise high. Do 11, do 4, do 4, do 11, speech. Dug, do 10, gladness, knees, lap, loins, member, motion plus throat-like chamber. To enjoy, to be, make enjoyable, sweet. Good, beautiful, favorable, pleasing, or fresh water. Dug 4, do 11. Speech, to speak, to order, command, to sing, to speak with, converse, with Da, to do, to make a notion in the throat. Do 14. Quarrel. Struggle. Fight. Again, all of the meanings are applicable. The Sumerian meaning of good. Good. The Germanic rendering of God. With X. But this is Sumerian. Domestic ox. Bull. Regularly followed by Ra. Gur 4. Hu-Bur. So the goddess Hu-Bur, related to Mamu Hu-Bur, is similar to the angel of the Lord. Hu means bird, and Bur means complaint, to complain. The Book of Malachi is a complaint from the bird man. Gur 4. Voice. Sound. With repetitive processing. Refers to the bellow of a bull. To dance. Leap. Gu'ud. Gu'dku. Gu'udku. Carp. Dancing. Leaping fish. Good. Gu'tu. Warrior. Good. Nest. The nest. Good 8. Short. The word Guda arises. Guda. Gudu. Gudug. I wonder if they have anything to do with the Udug or Utug, meaning pitfall, a demonic being. Or Udug Utug, a weapon. Anzu is the flood storm weapon, the divine storm bird. Yet again, all the meanings are applicable. Gudug, gudug, gudug. Where have I seen that before? In the WB 62, Sumerian Kings List Recension, Zuzudra. Or Zin Zudu of Shu-Ru-Pak, who is listed as the son of the last king of summer, before the great flood. He is recorded as having reigned as both king and Gudug priest. Zu-Zu-Dra. Here we have the old names for Odin and Anzu. Odin in High German is Zu, with the identical spelling. I believe Gudug is a variant of the Apkallu sages, the Ishipu, the Kalu. That would be the Udug priest, those who hold wisdom and knowledge, the wise men, the sages, the fear-mongerers. But both Zu and Zu also mean wisdom knowledge. Eshipu means exorcist, and the source of knowledge for the so-called wise ones is the good Udug and the bad Udug, together referred to as Udug Hul, an ambiguous class of demons. They are the Legion, the king of whom is Pazuzu, Pazuzu. The name of the Udug is It, the one who, from the beginning, had no name or form. The Sumerian term would be Imdugud, to be defined. It should never have been given a name. But the Ishipu, the Kalu, the Gudug, wrote the clay tablets, meaning the priest, as an author, as an oracle, is giving it both form and name. I think you'll agree, the amount of meanings allocated to the names is almost chaotic, and this is by design. Today I need to present an indisputable translation. In all, there are many variants, all of which lead to this god being fully defined. But because of all the variants, it is also very difficult to describe him by name. All in all, it's just another brick in the wall. Hence, I render the name Imdugud, the nest of the illustrious god, is in the clay tablets. The four authors of the Gospels, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, are often represented with their attributes, meaning they were attributed to them. The angel for Saint Matthew, the lion for Saint Mark, the ox for Saint Luke, and the eagle for Saint John. Together they form the three-headed beast with the wings of a bird. I leave you with the original Sumerian word for bird, because bird is the word. Everybody's heard about the bird and the word, haven't they, Peter?
Oh, crap.
Everybody's heard about the bird and the word, but it isn't a bird at all. Mushen means bird. Hu was the original word for bird. Mushen, Hu, Shu, Zu. But Mushen is more properly described as a flying reptile. Zu also means red. The phoenix would be the red dragon, the so-called good Udug. God good, is it Germanic or Sumerian? The answer is both, but which came first, the dragon or the egg?